Welcome to NASA's 2024 Human Exploration Rover Challenge here in Huntsville, Alabama. For the past 30 years, NASA has presented student teams from across the world with an engineering design challenge to engage them in the next phase of human space exploration. As the agency prepares to send humans to the moon through the Artemis campaign, the Human Exploration Rover Challenge tasks students with designing, constructing, and testing technologies that we could use to explore the moon and traverse unique environmental terrains. Months of hard work and preparation have led us to this weekend. High school and college teams have transported their student-built human-powered rovers to the U.S. Space and Rocket Center in the Rocket City, where the Rover Challenge is hosted. Over a two-day period, the teams will have two chances to traverse this approximately half-mile course that includes simulated lunar and Martian terrain.
The education these students are getting can now be applied to actual programs in the U.S. and internationally. That's what they have to look forward to. That's where these skills and this competition is now connected directly to Artemis, even more so today than it was 10 years ago, even more so today than it was 30 years ago. This is directly feeding our workforce for the lunar terrain vehicles and rovers that we need in the future and that we're actually working on.
So get ready, get set, and let's go. Take a look at NASA's 30th annual Human Exploration Rover Challenge. Students from 42 colleges and universities and 30 high schools from 24 states, the Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, and 12 other nations are competing in this year's Rover Challenge. Students have spent months designing, assembling, and testing their rovers for these 2 days of competition. Aside from making it through the course within the 8-minute time limit, teams can also complete mission tasks along the way to earn points. But teams have actually been earning points all season long by completing design reviews and making sure that their rover meets challenge criteria. The team with the highest number of points at the end of the project year in each category will be the winner of their respective division.
And it wasn't until 2014 that we changed to the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge to better match NASA's mission. And then in 2017, we took away the race aspect and we turned it into points. So you are accumulating points instead of just trying to become the fastest team. And then during COVID, we started to add different design reviews, operational readiness reviews, and presentations. So you accumulate points throughout the year and you come into the excursions with points already earned. So then you add to that with your excursion. So it's a broader scope of a project for the students.
Talk to me a little bit about the legacy of the moon buggy to the Human Exploration Rover Challenge.
So exciting to be here. This is my third time to come. And what I'm particularly impressed by is just how the community comes out to support it. The fact that 30 years, that's hard to continue that kind of energy level for these years. And to see these students and the work they do and the energy they put into is truly heartwarming.
Is there anything that you guys do as a team to kind of bond?
Oh yeah, we like to dance a lot. We like to teach everyone like bachata, merengue, something that like we do in our country. So something that we do to bond is just dance.
I don't think I've met a single team that has been slightly distant. Everyone is so warm and welcoming. And I mean, that's fantastic. Like we've gotten to speak to people from so many countries and it's been really friendly. So really enjoyed that. It's fantastic. The atmosphere is fantastic.
We've been doing this for 30 years. With that comes a great deal of history, a great deal of momentum. Rocket City, Huntsville, Alabama is the home of this activity. The U.S. Space and Rocket Center has been our partner for so long. And one of the amazing things about having a challenge that's been around that long, we have Marshall employees and Marshall contractors who remember their days being a part of a Human Exploration Rover team, finished their education, maybe went off and did master's degrees, worked as as a contractor, became a civil servant, and they attribute much of their early success in being ready for NASA work from having participated in the HERC many, many years ago. So it's been around quite a while, and we're really excited about it.
Marshall developed the Saturn V rocket that would launch the first humans that would land on the moon in 1969. During that same year, Marshall assumed the role of developing the lunar roving vehicle that would transport astronauts and material on the moon. During the Apollo 15 mission, astronauts utilized the LRV automotive vehicle on the moon for the first time. With this rover, astronauts were able to collect more lunar samples than the two previous moon missions combined, and they spent less time on the moon than the Apollo 14 mission. Taking inspiration from the LRV, the Rover Challenge aligns with NASA's goals for our new lunar exploration program, Artemis.
To me, HERC is the epitome of putting your mind, your hands, and your imagination together. NASA is involved in so many different educational and inspirational challenges, but this is really the only challenge where students are operating and manipulating hardware in order to solve real problems really address simulation of Earth, lunar and Mars surfaces and obstacle and task challenges that are different every year and are based on challenges that the actual rover teams are trying to resolve.
I think STEM is very important in high school because, unlike other subjects, I feel like it definitely helps you get engaged and understand things better. Because I think one of the biggest questions I had as a kid growing up was, you know, how do things work?
Coming in as a high school, we didn't think we were going to compete to the level of all these colleges. It's scary coming in as younger, not as experienced, not as much time and money. So when we placed that high last year, it was kind of a shock to us. And it was really rewarding to be able to know that we can compete with some of the highest universities.
As a robotics engineer, you obviously see very impressive things at JPL. What are you seeing that's impressed you here today by high schoolers, universities?
So definitely, like, you know, the amount of like rovers that I used to see when I was competing versus what I see now, the quality has gone up, the technology has gone up. I think they have more access to resources than we used to have. And I'm pretty impressed by these high schoolers coming up with this innovative designs and, like, you know, especially the wheels. Like, it just amazes me that high schoolers are working on some cool technology.
These students are what we call the Artemis generation. They're really going to be the ones that are designing the spacecrafts and the rovers and the landers and things that are actually going to put astronauts, explorers on the surface of the moon, not just for a visit, but for a sustained presence with the ultimate goal of having a presence on deeper into space, not just to the moon, but onto Mars.
You have to learn to push through in spite of different obstacles. Let's say a wheel break down. Okay, well, what are we gonna do? We're gonna go back to the engineering design process model and we're going to redesign. We're gonna come up with a solution on how to fix the problem. That's life. Problems will arise, and then the students, they just push through. I mean, some of these kids' funding didn't come through like they expected. Some of the kids' parts didn't come in on time, so now we have to design. We have to do a prototype that we hope to make in a final product. So being able to be flexible and adaptable in real time.
We were a public school, so our school district unfortunately wasn't able to help much. So it's basically completely community supported. You can see over there, there's a bunch of all the banks, the city, a bunch of companies helped us, and that's why we're here. We basically went door to door, radio, TV, a lot of interviews, and that's how we were able to get here.
Getting your rover here, what was that process like?
So we were back and forth on the phone with a lot of people in Indian customs, and we also had a parent in our team who worked with customs, so that was very helpful. So we had the box and we had the crate made, and it was, but the NASA letter really helped us.
All right, did you have any issues when it got here? Where everything was intact?
Everything was intact, but we had a few screws that were stripped off, so we had to get help from the machine shop to get them removed. Otherwise, thankfully, none of the welds broke, which we were really worried about.
During the two-day competition, a mobile machine shop is staffed by engineers from Marshall Space Flight Center who volunteer to assist students in repairs to their rovers as needed.
Inside the shop, we have a lathe and we have a Bridgeport mill, and then all of the tooling supplies that we could imagine. And then externally, we added a tent this year. We use that for all of the cut saws, the belt grinders, sanders, metal grinders, anything that could help the kids.
This is actually just one of our Artemis student challenges. There's actually a number of them. There's 7 or 8 of them. And you can find out, this is just one small part of what we have in STEM. STEM.nasa.gov has literally hundreds of different ways that students and educators can find out how they can connect with NASA, with our science resources. There's literally so many opportunities. This is a fun one, but there are so many other options out there as well.
Following 2 Artemis test missions, Artemis 3 will mark humanity's return to the moon in over 50 years. 4 astronauts will depart from Launch Pad 39B at NASA's Kennedy Space Center, inside the Orion spacecraft atop the Space Launch System rocket. The crew will travel inside Orion to lunar orbit. There, the human landing system will take the crew from Orion down to the surface of the moon. And once there, the astronauts will begin their scientific work. This student design challenge encourages the Artemis generation of scientists and engineers to provide innovative concepts and unique perspectives on how we could best achieve the agency's human exploration goals. It also provides valuable experience to students who may one day plan future space missions, including crewed missions to other worlds.
Oh, it feels amazing. When I was a little kid, I used to read all the time about rovers. I remember watching movies and wanted to make one myself. And it's amazing being able to do it and also coming here to NASA, testing it. It feels like a real engineer when you are just starting to become one. So it has been a really good experience.
We can inspire kids and in general people to go into the STEM area without fear or thinking that it has to be something very complicated. But like this, it's a really good example of how with some stuff that you may have at your house, you can do amazing things.
At NASA's Human Exploration Rover Challenge, many awards are given out, including those to teams who excelled in their social media presence, showcased exceptional STEM engagement efforts, and of course, who are overall winners of both the high school and college divisions.
We're so glad that you're here today. What a phenomenal day we've had here in Huntsville, Alabama at the Space and Rocket Center. This is our Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2024, 30 years. Everybody say, Herc. It's my pleasure to announce the winner of the first place award in the high school division for the 2024 Human Exploration Rover Challenge, and that goes to Parish Episcopal School.
We were feeling really amazing. Last year we had a setback on the second day, and this year we came back with just a lot of energy, and we worked really hard throughout the season, so we're just feeling really excited, and the hard work has paid off.
Please join me in congratulating the winner of the College University Division for NASA's 2024 Human Exploration Rover Challenge, better known as HERC, and that award goes to the University of Alabama, Huntsville.
And how's everybody feeling?
We are feeling great. We know it's really been a team effort. Every single person on this team has contributed to this project, and we could not be more proud of how our work this year has rewarded us.
Any challenges you had to overcome? I know you. This is, years in the making. Y'all won last year as well, so.
Lots of challenges to overcome. The big part was the teamwork that we put in, finding all the parts to make things work, and a huge part of that was the contributions from every one of our team. We always talked about how we were so stunned that we got a group of so many people that were willing to really put their heart and soul into this, and we could not have done it without each and every one of us.
And with that, we wrap up NASA's 2024 Human Exploration Rover Challenge. Some of these students will be back next year to compete again, while others will go on to begin their careers and may even end up at NASA working to send humanity back to the moon through the Artemis campaign. Regardless of where these students end up, this weekend of fun but challenging competition will leave them all with lasting memories. So on behalf of NASA, we thank each of you for being a part of the Artemis generation.